Saturn's majestic, iconic rings define the planet. But where did they come from?
Saturn's rings. Good question. And the answer is different depending on which ring we're discussing.
That's Dr. Kevin Grazier, a planetary scientist who worked on NASA's Cassini mission for over 15 years, studying Saturn's rings extensively.
Saturn's rings, the strange things about Saturn's rings is that they shouldn't be there, really, in the sense that they don't last for very long. So if they are just left over from when Saturn was formed, they'd be gone by now. They would slowly work their way into Saturn and burn up and be gone, and yet they're there. So they are either relatively new or somehow continuously regenerated. Continuously regenerated seems strange. Relatively new also seems kind of strange. Something broke up, a moon broke up, a large comet broke up. Something had to have happened relatively recently, and by relatively recently, you know, that means hundreds of millions of years ago to someone like me.
And that's Mike Brown, professor of planetary geology at Caltech. He studies many of the icy objects in the solar system. Saturn's rings start just about 7,000 kilometers above the surface of the planet and extend out to an altitude of 80,000 kilometers. But they're gossamer thin, just 10 kilometers across at some points. We've known about Saturn's rings since 1610, when Galileo was the first person to turn a telescope on them. The resolution was primitive, and he thought he saw handles attached to Saturn, or perhaps what were big moons on either side. In 1659, using a better telescope, the Dutch astronomer Christiaan Huygens figured out that these handles were actually rings. And finally, in the 1670s, the Italian astronomer Giovanni Cassini was able to resolve the rings in more detail, even observed the biggest gap in the rings. The Cassini mission, named after Giovanni, has been with Saturn for almost a decade and allowed us to view the rings in incredible detail. Determining the origin and evolution of Saturn's rings has been one of its objectives. So far, the argument continues.
There's an age-old debate whether the main rings are old or new, and that goes back and forth, and it's been going back and forth for ages, and it still goes back and forth. Are they old? Have they been there for a long period of time? Are they new? And right now, I don't know what to think, to be quite honest. I'm not being wishy-washy. I just don't know what to think anymore.
Evidence from NASA's Voyager spacecraft indicated that the material in Saturn's rings was young. Perhaps a comet shattered one of Saturn's moons within the last few hundred million years, creating the rings we see today. But if that was the case, what incredible luck that we're here to see the rings in their current form. But when Cassini arrived, it showed evidence that Saturn's rings were being refreshed, which could explain why they appear so young. Perhaps they're ancient after all.
If Saturn's rings were old, a moon could have gotten too close to Saturn and been pulled apart by tidal stresses. Could have been a collision of moons. It could have been a pass by a nearby object. Since in the early days of planetary formation, there were many objects zooming past Saturn. Saturn probably had a halo of material in its early days of material that was loosely bound to the moon.
But there's one ring that we know for certain is being refreshed.
The E-ring certainly is a new ring, because the E-ring consists of roughly micron-sized ice particles. And micron-sized ice particles don't last in space. They sputter, they sublimate, they go away on short time periods, and we knew that. So when we went to Saturn with Cassini, we knew to look for a source of material, because we knew that the individual components of the E-ring don't last. So it has to be replenished. So the E-ring certainly stands alone from the main ring system, and the E-ring is absolutely new.
In 2005, scientists discovered that Saturn's E-ring is being constantly replenished by the moon Enceladus. Cryovolcanoes spew water ice into space from a series of fissures at its south pole. So where did Saturn's rings come from? We don't know. Are they new or old? We don't know. It's just another great mystery of the solar system.
Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel here. And maybe you still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see what you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.
What made the temperature tolerance of my brain?